Hi everybody, I'm Andrea. Welcome to part two of our online video workshop on sunflower designs on hand-painted clothes or anything else you'd like. Like my page, remember, and keep coming back because we're going to be constantly posting new designs that you can follow along with and join us for our workshops, okay? And please, feel free to send me feedback, send me some comments, insight, whatever you'd like to see done. Maybe you have a design idea that you would like to see done, and I can go ahead and show that particular one in a workshop for you, okay? So we've done part one of this design, and I hope you've seen that. So we have the sunflowers here in a nice composition on the shoulder of this shirt. And what we're going to do is add the leaves now. And what I've decided was before in part one, I put some stems with the heart-shaped leaves in a different kind of a composition. But stepping back and taking a look at this and seeing the canvas that I have to work with, I'm going to tighten it up and just add the leaves around this design. But I'm only going to put three. I like to do my designs in odd numbers. One, three, and fives. So you can do whatever you'd like, but I find it more visually pleasing to use odd numbers. Remember the 1-3-5 rule, okay? So we've got two sunflowers, we're going to add three leaves, and that's five. So it's I like that type of a composition. So let's get started. First thing we're going to do is we're going to create a little bit more depth in the core of the sunflower. So I've taken the copper, I've darkened it a tiny bit with some purple, okay? And I'm going to use a stenciling brush, and I'm going to load my brush up a small amount, and I'm just going to go ahead and tap around one side. Just one side. I don't want to do too much of the same thing, too much symmetry, because then you lose the feeling of the depth of the design. So I tap around one side and tap around the other side, get a little bit more detail in there, a little bit more depth. We're again layering these colors. I'm going to even go a little bit crazy, a little darker here. Now I'm going to see if you can appreciate what's happening here, okay? You've got some very nice things going on, some interesting effects here going on, and you can see that there's a little bit more of the seeds popping through. Okay, so we've created a nice look there. Now off to the leaves. We need some water, and I've taken very light green and a darker green, and we're going to start with the light green first. As I explained to you in part one, we like to layer the colors, and we like to start with the darker colors, the lighter colors first. So let's mix this up a little bit and get a nice viscosity. Not too thin, because that will really bleed. And not too thick, because then you have a very heavy, chunky look, and we don't want that. So we want just this perfect texture like this. And again, we're going to sketch it by tapping. And I'd like to put one leaf here, and one that brings the design up to the shoulder, okay? Let's stay with that. The leaves are heart-shaped, so I'm just going to kind of tap in a nice, loose leaf here. Load up the brush, fill it in. Again, we're going to layer, so let's just, this is our basic shape, and then another up here to bring your eye up, and I like the way that looks on a shirt. You don't have to worry too much about the shape. Again, nature is not perfect. It has shapes and torn leaves and kinds of things that fill this in. And it's nice if you can do a lighter pigment on one side, darker on the other. Now we're going to do the third here. I'm going to do a little smaller one that's like peeking out a little bit. Just tap in the green. That. Okay. Now I need a little bit more water because I'm going to darken this green. But I'm going to use the same green and just pull in another shade of green. So we have that nice lime green coming through in our layer. Now what I like to do is go to the edge and pull it in. Go to the edge. Tap that nice color on top. A little bit more. Okay. Now maybe we'll just leave this side alone. That's nice. Now a little bit darker. And again, I like that the paints are all on one palette, so you can decide how much of the darker color you want in your green, okay? So now we're going to, I like to kind of define the edges a little bit. Maybe make a line down here. Off to the side a little bit. Okay, like this. Now, remember what we're going to do with our watercolor effect brush, this medium-shaped brush. We're going to put clean water on it and tap on these paints so the colors bleed together. We have that lovely watercolor effect. On the inside of the leaf, don't tap it on the outside because then you get a bleed from the outside. And you want to keep that line crisp. Tapping, okay. There we go. Now you can see how that is beginning to happen. How that bleeding is beginning to happen. I just love the way that looks. So we're finished. You can take this design and do whatever you'd like. You can flip the shirt over and maybe make one sunflower on the back of the shirt. That's a very nice look. You can add more layers. I think that less is more. So once you've seen the colors that you like, just walk away, you know, and then come back later and maybe add some more. So I hope that you're successful, and I hope you join us on our next online workshop, How to Hand Paint Your Own Clothes. Remember, like my page and follow along with all our workshops, okay? Blue Eyed Horse Studio, see you next time. Bye!